This was the moment in 2009 when Joe McElderry won the X Factor. Nothing shocking about that. But at that very moment, several miles away in a bedroom in Chelmsford, this man was plotting to change the course of telly talent history.
I set up the campaign for one reason only, which was to regain the Christmas number one. The X Factor had had the Christmas number one for the last previous 4 years, and it was getting boring.
Steve Brookstein, Leona Lewis, Leon Jackson, Shane Ward. People are like fed up of it, you know, you let someone else get the number one spot. But I think people would have like downloaded anything literally to overthrow Cowell's empire.
And I love the shock element of it was great, because at the beginning when you just heard about the campaign, you thought they've got no chance, you can't go up against X Factor. But
he did, and Rage Against the Machine made the national news.
After taking the coveted Christmas number one spot, a huge internet campaign saw the US band topple Joe McElderry with their 1992 release Killing in the Name.
I felt so sorry for Joe McElderry because he took the brunt. He wasn't the target, it was definitely Simon and the X Factor machine.
Armed only with a popular social networking site, John Morter had taken on the very might of this machine and won.
We had, at one point, 1.1 million members in my Facebook group. And obviously, it was a Christmas number one. It got the Guinness record for the most downloads in a week. It's in the Guinness book now. And it just seem to just take over the world.
It's the Christmas number one for 2009, Rage Against the Machine and Killing the Name Of.
But it could have been any song. It could have been, you know, 10 Green Bottles on a dance mix.
I had some explaining to do to my mother on Christmas Day why this noisy, loud rap metal song was playing just before the Queen. It felt quite surreal.
Even Simon saw the funny side, eventually.
I was very, very shocked to get a phone call from Simon Cowell. And he was really congratulatory. He thought it was a great campaign, and he actually thought that we'd done our bit to just, you know, give the charts a bit of a kick, a bit of a shot, really.
And so, in the end, everyone was happy. Well, almost everyone.
Why does the media keep thinking that Rage the Machine beat Simon? No, it didn't. It played more into his hands. It gave him more publicity. It gave him more chance to stick his fingers up to the world. And, you know, it's on his label. So not only did he win three times, he got a full trick. You can never beat him. He's got three aces, three threes, and a pile of bloody kings. And everybody feels sorry for him.